This is a video presentation of the paper titled Overview of Wireless Power Communication Network. First, what is WPCN? It is a combination of wireless communication network, for example, mobile network, and wireless directional power transmission. But why do we need WPCN? As in recent years, the Internet of Things and home automation industry are expanded exponentially. This industry requires very efficient communication network model. So with WPCN, we can cut the very last wire to all devices to achieve truly wireless so that they can be charged wirelessly. It is cost effective, environment friendly, and easier to deploy as no power cord is being needed. There are two basic models to implement WPCN, separator and hybrid. In separator model, the EN and AP are separately located, whereas in hybrid model, the EN and AP pair is co-located and integrated as HAP. The HAP makes the coordination of information and energy transmission easier as compared to separate AP and EN. It also helps save production and operation costs. However, it also induces a design challenge which is known as linear far problem. WPCN can be operated at half and full duplex mode. In full duplex mode, the power and data are scheduled to transmit separately on different frequency band or different time slot. In full duplex mode, the power and data transmit simultaneously. Now, we will introduce four techniques to enhance the performance of WPCN. The first technique is energy beamforming. With this technique, the energy signal at different antenna are weighted to achieve constructive superposition at intended ER. This requires accurate knowledge of channel state information for ET. For forward link training, channel estimation and feedback is done by ER. More accurate CSI knowledge can be obtained by the ET if the ER uses more energy to perform channel estimation and feedback. For reverse link training, channel estimation is done by ET without any feedback from the ER. Joint communication and energy scheduling is designed to avoid cross-channel interference and optimize the overall system performance. It uses a technique of time frequency resource block, which can be allocated dynamically either to the HAP for energy transfer in the downlink or to the WDs for information transmission in the uplink. For example, we have HAP with three wireless devices with different distance. It improves by allocating more resource block to far user WD2 and less to near user WD1. It could also occur that no transmission is scheduled at some resource block because of pure wireless channel condition due to fading. Another key technique is wireless power cooperative communication. By deploying this technique, communication and energy cooperation can be achieved. Let's take an example. We have a HAP and two wireless devices. WD1 is closer to the HAP, whereas WD2 is further away. Firstly, HAP performs WPT. WD2 can transmit its data to the WD1 for decoding, and messages are then decoded together and sent to the HAP. So WD2 can benefit from shorter communication range compared to the direct communication with the HAP. WD1 experienced low data rate in this cooperation, but it also allowed the HAP to allocate more time for data transmission instead of WPT. Besides, the wireless device can also perform peer-to-peer energy cooperation. For example, WD1 can transmit excessive energy to WD2. This technique can also apply to separate EN and AP. The EN, AP, and HAP can also cooperate to achieve more efficient energy and information transmission. They can be interconnected by wire and wireless backhaul link for exchanging signal. This technique is known as multi-node cooperation. For downlink energy transfer, the cooperating EN form a virtual multi-input multi-output system to perform distributed energy beamforming to maximize the received energy at target WD. The downlink energy transfer and uplink information transmission can be performed simultaneously on the same frequency band as AP can perform cell interference cancellation. One design consideration for this technique is the placement of EN and AP when the WD are fixed in location. The number and location of EN and AP need to be determined to maximize the performance. In addition to these four techniques, there are two trends driving the future of WPCN. Green energy has sparked a hot topic among the public. Thus, energy harvester can be combined with WPT to build a greener WPCN. Also, in order to keep the existing communication network and WPCN coexist, WPCN should be made connective so that interference between them can be avoided. This is known as connective WPCN. To conclude, we believe that WPCN will be an important building block for wireless communication system and definitely bring us a better future. This video is presented by Wei Hong, Shen Yan, and Minter.